Welcome back, everyone. For this second part of this workshop, we will start with launching one new tool we have developed within Cegal, called the Integrated Python Tool, or Tool Integrated with Petrel. I'll leave the presentation to Sebastian. So Sebastian, please go ahead with your presentation.
Yeah, thanks, Stoffe. Welcome everyone to the next section of the Cegal Data Science Day. My name is Sebastian Grebe. I'm the product manager for Python Tool Pro, which I will present to you in the next 20 minutes. We are proud to have the opportunity as part of this forum to present to you for the first time Cegal's newest product, Python Tool Pro, which fully connects the world of Petrel with the world of Python. Python Tool Pro enables you to expose your Petrel data to the complete data science lifecycle. Cegal's target with this and future products is to enable more data science against Petrel. The connection between Python Tool Pro and Petrel is very easy to establish, enabling a user to run highly advanced workflows from your preferred IDE. Python Tool Pro will be released to market in the coming weeks. Our goal is to position ourselves as a leading enabler of data science against Petrel and other GNG environments. We want to create and enable data science environments that are optimized for GNG by facilitating data flow, tooling, visualizations around legacy applications and data. In doing this, we will remain agnostic and importantly focus on an enabling role rather than an algorithmic role. Our goal is to allow clients to easily use their Petrel data with the preferred data science workflows and algorithms. We are not necessarily going to build our own algorithms in this domain. Python Tool Pro is the next step on this journey. We will continue to expand our offerings that enable clients to leverage more value from the legacy data in the preferred data science environment. The original Python tool in Blueback Toolbox was introduced to enable Petrel users to write customizable Python scripts within Petrel directly against domain objects. Python tool accesses libraries such as NumPy and scikit-learn to solve problems that are not possible with native Petrel. It allows users to be creative beyond the limits of the Petrel calculator and store scripts in Petrel to create a reusable code base. The toolbox implementation supports a variety of Petrel domain objects and also enables running Python scripts in a Petrel workflow. The existing Python tool within the toolbox has become a very popular product over the last 12 months. However, it does have some limitations. The current solution relies on correctly deployed Anaconda environments and does not provide the complete IDE experience that users may expect. Python Tool Pro is a natural evolution of the original Python implementation in the toolbox. Therefore, Python Tool Pro has been designed to take the data science experience in and against Petrel one step further. Python Tool Pro allows users to connect into Petrel and access Petrel data easily and efficiently from an external Python installation on platforms like Anaconda to enable a full IDE experience. It becomes possible to use any Python libraries without risking conflicts on Petrel dependencies. Python Tool Pro enables users to leverage the preferred machine learning algorithms, neural networks, research code, and data science workflows against their Petrel data. This evolution provides many benefits, such as the utilization of user-friendly and powerful Jupyter notebooks against Petrel domain objects, easier installation, automation of scripts, update Petrel objects live when running scripts for immediate data visualization and QC. Python scripts or research code can be elevated and contextualized with markdown script, narrative text, documentation, or images. This will make it easier for others to understand your Python code when sharing your work with colleagues and partners. You can take full advantage of powerful visualizations from Python libraries such as matplotlib and use state-of-the-art machine learning libraries as TensorFlow. Or you can write full GUI applications, hiding complex code from the users. Python applications can be developed by specialized teams and then be distributed behind the user interface to a wider audience. They can then run advanced data science algorithms without having to learn the details of Python coding, thus removing the entry barrier for less Python-enabled users. Finally, external Python clients can use cloud services, other APIs, databases, and other data sources to incorporate more data and resources into your environment and analysis. So, as you can see, there are many benefits to the evolution of this technology. Next, I would like to demonstrate to you some of Python Tool Pro's functionalities and showcase the potential of Cegal's newest data science enabling product. I will begin this demo by showing you how easy it is to establish a connection to Petrel, and will then go through some basic workings of Python Tool Pro. We will then use some of these code examples to retrieve well-logged data from Petrel, applying a smoothing algorithm in our Jupyter notebook, and send the results back to Petrel. In the next example, we will create a k-means classification on the same well and investigate how the results are affected by different parameters. We will see how changing the input will update the Petrel data outputs dynamically. In the last example, we will apply a complex fault prediction on a seismic cube using a neural network algorithm from a public research code. Again, we will see how running the code in our Jupyter notebook will stream live updates of the results to Petrel. During this demo, we will connect to an active Petrel session with an open project called Petrel Demo Project. Now, we will simply connect into the active Petrel project from Python Tool Pro by using a method called Petrel Connection. On the Petrel side, a plugin is running a gRPC server to establish this connection. Here we can now see that the connection has been established as the active project is returned as a result of this query. Python Tool Pro enables the user to retrieve data from Petrel using various classes and methods. We will now look at various domain objects supported in Python Tool Pro. In our Jupyter notebook, we can access the API help from Python Tool Pro directly. By hitting Shift and Tab, you can see information about the method or class you are currently working on. In this case, you can see how to access the well logs from Python Tool Pro. Or you can use intelligence like this to see what functionalities are available at each point of writing your Python code. In the next cell, we will retrieve a 3D model grid and a seismic cube from Petrel by using either the Petrel grid or the Petrel path in the input tree. You can then look at different properties of the objects, like displaying the name of the 3D grid and the coordinates of a specific cell. Or you can check the spatial extent of the seismic cube. One of the many benefits of running Python Tool Pro in an external Python environment is the possibility to let users go through workflows without the need to write code. So we can hide the code. And in this case, the user will only see a drop-down menu from which they can select a well. And by simply clicking the button Get Well Logs, they get information about the well logs of the selected well. So here we can quickly see and access a listing of well logs and get a summary of the number of continuous and discrete logs in that well. The user can then simply switch the wells and retrieve the well log summary for another well. Now, clearly we want to not only retrieve and visualize data, but we also want to work with that data. Python Tool Pro allows you to load Petrel data into a pandas data frame, which enables easy manipulation, slicing, and selection of specific data. So here we load the data into the data frame. And we created a data frame called logsdf from the continuous logs in the A10 well. And then we slice the data frame to include only logs of interest and are displaying a predetermined depth range. We can then easily get statistics on the well logs in our data frame. So if we do that here, so running the statistics on the data frame, we get information about our logs like min, max, and mean, and can visualize the distribution of a specific log. Here's a gamma ray log in a histogram, and display the statistics in a box plot. So we can see the mean is at 82 API. We can show the upper and lower quartile of the data and the range of all the values. So there are many libraries in Python you can use to visualize your Petrel data in a Jupyter notebook. In this case, we're using the publicly available matplotlib to quickly and easily visualize and QC the selected well data from the Petrel project that we want to analyze and process. In the next step, we apply a smoothing algorithm on the well logs we selected from Petrel. And as we loaded the logs into a data frame, we can use the inbuilt pandas data frame functions for this. In this case, we use a Gaussian filter for the calculation, but any Python function can be used and applied on the data we loaded from Petrel into Jupyter. With matplotlib, we can then overlay the smooth log curves on the original well data. And we can see now how the smooth logs show up in the graph as the black lines here over the original well logs. After creating the smooth logs in Python Tool Pro, we can then seamlessly write the results back to Petrel. And Python Tool Pro will allow us to create a copy of the porosity log, which will show up in Petrel with the desired name syntax, in this case, porosity smooth. The same functionality to create clones of data objects for writing results back to Petrel is available for many other supported data objects. So if we run this code, we can see how the new log appears in Petrel, and initially it is empty until we transfer the values from Python Tool Pro to Petrel. So that's what we're going to do now, and we're going to return the smooth logs that we have generated in Python back to Petrel. And as you can see, the smooth log created in the previous step is now visible in the well section window. So this was a simple example of how easy it is to access Petrel data from your external Python environment, then analyze, manipulate, and stream results back to Petrel. Next, we will run a k-means classification on the selected well to determine a new facies log and write back various permutations of the classification live to Petrel to visualize the effects of the facies, which is currently an empty log in the well section window. So we have the empty facies log in here. And in this menu, we will select the porosity and gamma and run the k-means classification. And here we can see how this dual input creates a nice separation between the facies, and the log, which was previously empty, now shows a facies classification. And if we run the algorithm again, including the permeability log, we can see how the log in Petrel gets updated, like this. If we compare the scatter plots and the histogram in the Jupyter notebook, we can see how the distribution of the facies changes. So you could now run this k-means classification on your other worlds in Petrel, or you can use it as an input for a machine learning classifier here in Python Tool Pro, or upload it to a different cloud application. This is a workflow which we will see in a later presentation today. So this smoothing well logs and k-means classification are two relatively simple workflows many of you will be familiar with. They have been used in this demo to illustrate how easy it is to connect into Petrel using Python Tool Pro, visualize and manipulate Petrel data in your IDE, and dynamically stream results back to Petrel. In the final example, I'd like to show you a more complex workflow by applying a neural network. So this is a workflow which is based on research code published on GitHub and is implemented using public libraries. We will apply a neural network algorithm to create a fault prediction on seismic data in Petrel and live stream the results of the prediction back to Petrel. So we can reuse the connection the existing connection from Python Tool Pro into the same Petrel project and retrieve a seismic cube by selecting it from the drop-down menu. So I'm going to select my seismic cube one, which we're going to use for this workflow. And from the selected cube, we will access a small chunk, which we can then visualize within the Jupyter notebook for QC purposes. So here we can then easily see the chunk from the seismic in Petrel in our Jupyter notebook. In the next step, we will use a pre-trained model, which is saved here, to apply a neural network fault prediction on the selected seismic chunk. With Python Tool Pro, it is possible to access complex code from a separate Python file. So we have the Python code in the file faultpredict/.py. And what I'm illustrating with this is that Python code can be written by a data scientist or domain expert and then be distributed to Petrel users for consumption or even hidden behind a user interface to simplify user interaction. And this enables users with less coding experience to run advanced data science algorithms on the Petrel data by removing their barrier to entry. So all we have to do here is now call the file in our Jupyter notebook. And if we run this, we can see how we created a fault model from the seismic input, which we can now send back to Petrel. So if we go back into Petrel and look at the seismic, so this is the original seismic from which we will now create a copy in the Jupyter notebook. So in Python Tool Pro, we will then create a clone of the original seismic with the same geometry. And we can see the seismic input appears in Petrel as an empty seismic cube. The fault prediction we ran on the seismic chunk can now be applied on the seismic data in Petrel. So we run the apply calculator, and we can see now how the Petrel seismic is updated live as the fault prediction is running chunk by chunk through the entire seismic cube in Petrel. Yeah, so that concludes the demo and the launch of Python Tool Pro. But hopefully I've illustrated through both relatively simple and more complex examples the benefits that Python Tool Pro brings to enabling more data science against Petrel. Importantly, enabling the utilization of user-friendly and powerful Jupyter notebooks against Petrel domain objects, the ease of connection into Petrel, and the immediate access to Petrel data for use in your desired data science workflows and algorithms. The live link to Petrel objects when running scripts for media data visualization and QC, and how we can now enable you to take full advantage of powerful visualizations from Python libraries such as matplotlib, or use state-of-the-art machine learning libraries as TensorFlow against Petrel data. So thank you very much for your attention, and we will now answer any questions you posted into the webinar chat window.
Hi, I'm James Goldwater. I've been attending this. I've been a developer on this project, and Stoff has asked me to go through some of the questions that have been asking. So one of the questions was, can you import 3D grids as arrays? Sebastian demonstrated there that yes, all of our domain objects, which are appropriate like seismic and grid properties, we offer a comprehensive chunking API where you can request one or two or 3D chunks either by line or layer or trace or 3D. So you don't have to run into large memory management problems. One of the questions is, can I do this without opening the Petrel project in Petrel? No, at the moment, it's a system to connect a local Petrel with your local Python distribution. In the future, we're hoping to enhance this capability, and I'm sure we'll be in touch about that. Licensing and pricing questions, I am going to defer to our sales team, who will, I'm sure, follow up on this. I don't know much about it, I'm afraid. Python compatibility, it's designed to be compatible with Python 3.6 and above. So any flavor of Python should be okay. On Windows, there's nothing inherent about Windows support, but of course Petrel runs on Windows. I have a question. I had the impression that you were using HD5 as the seismic format. We're not using HD5 as a seismic format. We defer to Petrel for all of that. One of the problems that, for instance, Python tool in Toolbox had is that Petrel uses a certain version of an HD5 library, which can cause compatibility problems. Python Tool Pro removes all compatibility problems with Petrel. So you can use any set of Python libraries that you want. And I have another question. Do you have plans to turn this into an open source project in the spirit of Python libraries? I know of no plans to do that. And again, I'll defer to our sales and marketing teams to plan this further out in the roadmap. The Python external libraries are dependent on the Petrel installation. No, it is possible to use whatever additional Python library you want. All project objects, can we access them? We offer support for a wide range of Petrel domain objects, but not all of them yet. We offer support for grids, properties, seismic, surfaces, point set attributes, well logs, global well logs, and I'm sure I've forgotten a couple there. We are, of course, very open to extending this to cover whatever domain objects customers need. Python tool, yes, it can access Seaborn, Plotly, and Pandas as well. Sebastian demonstrated Pandas there. A previous version of this presentation showed a nice Seaborn plot. Can the seismic cube from Petrel Link be processed with the same libraries that utilize SIGI format? SegY format? No. The API presents the user the data as NumPy arrays, which are hopefully a lot more flexible and usable than SGY format. There are many Python libraries for dealing with raw SegY data, and an interesting workflow might be to combine Petrel data with external SegY data. The brilliant thing about Python, as we all know, is that with its huge ecosystem, you can combine data sources with the minimum effort. Does the tool provide an easy way to cache or persist data outside of Petrel? For example, so I can continue to work on data without having to be connected all the time and then reconnect later to send results back. The tool itself does not, because you don't need an easy way in the tool. The data is generally provided as NumPy arrays or pandas data frames, which means both of which can be saved to outside of Petrel with a single line of code and loaded back in again later on. So yes, you're not trapped inside the Python Tool Pro connection for all time.